Okay, so let's check out the amp envelope. First, let me change it to a saw wave. Excellent. So here we got the envelope, amp envelope. We actually have three, but we'll start talking about just the volume envelope. We have attack, decay, sustain, release. So attack is how long does it take the amp, the volume, to reach peak level. So if it's a fast attack, the sound will happen immediately or full volume. And if I bring it up a tiny bit or longer, it's gonna take time to build up volume. Nice. Decay is how long does it take the sound to reach the sustain level. As you can see, attack, decay, and release are time-based, and sustain is amount-based, volume, dB. So how long is it gonna take the volume to reach the sustain level? And release is how long does it take the sound to reach back to silence after we release the note, or more immediately. Nice. We can change the slopes of the attack, decay, and release. You can even go here to the second tab to change the slopes, which will give you a different behavior of the movement of the amp in this case. Oh. Nice. Now right here, we can change how the envelope is behaving. So now it's just gonna behave like a regular ADSR envelope. Trigger will ignore the sustain stage, and basically it doesn't matter how long you hit the note, it will just go through the entire envelope. So let me bring it to be a bit shorter here. So it doesn't matter how long I hit it, it's gonna do the attack, decay, and release. If the release is short, it doesn't matter how long. And there's a lot of uses for it. We'll check it when we check the other envelopes and the matrix. Loop will loop the envelope. So if I have it, let's say right here, pretty short, just looping it. Give it some more release. You can create some interesting patterns that are not synchronized because it's just looping the envelope that is based on milliseconds and seconds. And that is all about the amp envelopes. Next time we'll check the other two envelopes, including the matrix, which then things start to get interesting. Okay, catch you next time.